Lie on the doctor. Call the doctor. Doc, what do you think, Doc? What's going to take, Doc? Give me a shot, Doc. Give me a pill, right. Doc. Amen. And some of us going for rub downs and amen, all kind of stuff. But our faith in God, he said, it's needful for me to write to you to have faith in God.
Amen. And
when you got a problem, we used to say, if you got a problem, God can
solve
it. Do what?
Solve.
Yeah, but we put in God can solve them now and say, I'm going to find somebody to take care of it for me.
Yeah, I got a doctor.
Amen.
Amen.
So Jude says, it's needful for me to write to you. I've got to write to you. I know you church folks and you're the beloved of God. You love God.
Yes, yes.
But I've got to write to you and tell you, you've got to watch your faith. Watch
Amen.
Your faith. Amen. While you're saved, while you're shouting, jumping, dancing, carrying on, he said, watch, make sure you keep on believing
yes.
God.
Yes.
Amen. Don't get overcome by the shout, the dance, and amen, the quickening and speaking in some kind of tongue. Amen. He said, but watch your faith, because your faith is the thing that keeps you moving in God.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Without faith, it's impossible to please God.
Amen.
Is that right?
Yes,
amen.
Sir.
God wants us to have faith in God. Jesus said, have faith in God.
Uh-huh.
Amen. In other words, you got to believe what God said in the scripture. Now, notice what he said. He said, not only that, but he gave a couple other words that I want to capitalize on now. It's needful, and I exhort you. Yeah. I exhort you. In other words, I feel I'm begging, strongly urging you.
Mm-hmm.
I appeal to you. I'm encouraging you. Don't lose your faith.
Yes, yes.
Notice what he said. He said, I exhort you. I'm praying for you. I'm believing you, but I'm exhorting you. Don't lose your faith. Amen. We that have been walking with God and talking with God and shouting and dancing and speaking in tongues and singing and carrying on. Amen. You can do all that without faith.
Uh-huh. Yes.
You can learn how to do that. But he said, have faith in God. Now, if I have faith in God, what do? I have faith in what he says in his word. And I submit myself to what the word of God says when I have faith in him. I believe he means what he said. I believe he said what he means.
Amen.
So he said, it's needful for me to write to you.
Yes.
Amen. You think you've got it going and working for you, but it's need for me to write for you to have faith in God.
Yes, sir.
Believe God's word. Don't just take it and shake it and think it's all there is to it. But you've got to take it. The Lord said to Jeremiah, he said, eat the whole roll.
The whole roll.
Ezekiel.
Yes,
he said, eat the whole roll. Don't just take part of it. Thank God, this is wonderful. This is wonderful. It is wonderful serving the Lord. But he wants us to walk by faith. The just shall live by
faith.
His faith, yes. And so that's why it becomes very, very necessary for us to talk about this word of faith, that we don't lose our faith in God and get our faith sometimes set in ourselves.
Yes, sir.
I'm able to do this. I can do this. I can do that. And I know this and I know that. But he said, it's need for me to write to you to be careful about your faith.
Yes.
Oh, God.
My God.
I don't know if this scripture means much to you, but it means a lot to me.
Yes.
I'm going to exhort you that you earnestly, that means conscientiously, contend with much thought and understanding of God's plans for your life.
Sir.
You got to think about this thing. Amen. You didn't just happen to get here. God brought you here.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So you got to think about what God's doing in your faith. Contend for the faith. For you have a rival. You will have to put up a fight, a battle, a race. You must conquer your foe that wants to cause doubt in your mind.
Mm-hmm.
The devil comes and make you think that you already got it made.
Yes, sir.
But you don't have it made unless you have faith in God and you're obedient to God. Amen?
Amen.
So the Lord said here, Jude said here, he said,
that you should earnestly.
That you should earnestly contend for the faith. Uh-huh.
Which was once delivered unto the saints.
Now, that's the thing you got to. He said, one time the saints it was delivered to them. He said, well, when did the Lord deliver faith to the saints? All you have to do is read the book of Hebrews chapter 11, and you find out what God did.
Yes, sir.
God delivered faith to the saints in a time of disaster, He said, have faith in God. They got out there and they looked up and said, Lord, what are we going to eat? We're going to have a grave to bury our dead in. Moses done brought us out of Egypt. God said, oh, listen to what he tells you. He stretched out his rod and the sea opened up for them.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
He said that was delivered to the saints. Now, what God delivered to the saints, he delivered the same thing to us. And he told us to preach the word. That's why Jesus called 12 disciples and gave them faith in God. And they went preach the word. Now what we have, we're supposed to have the same thing that they had. Mm-hmm. We're not supposed to have some different kind of faith. Our faith, it was once delivered to the saints. And we look and see what the saints had, then we can find out what we're supposed to have.
All right.
No wonder he said it's needful for me to write to you. Mm-hmm. You don't have what we don't have what they had.
Yes, sir. Man.
They walked by faith, they lived by faith. Some of them were burned at the stake, but they kept their faith. And the end of the chapter of 11 chapter said, these all died in the faith and wouldn't receive deliverance because they wanted to believe God to the very end.
That's right.
Amen. Sometimes we believe God until something goes wrong and then we quit.
Yeah. Go ahead, brother. Amen.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. But we've got to believe God all the way.
Amen.
These all believe, it was once delivered to the saints. And I begin to look at Hebrews chapter 11. I saw what God gave to the saints. I said, God, there's something wrong with what we got today. Amen. We get so happy with just been getting a good song and shooting off the mouth. Amen. And saying good things. And it's good what you're saying and what you're doing. But he said, you've got to contend for the kind of faith the saints had.
Yes.
They were burned at the stakes. They were ridiculed. They were crucified, some of them. Some of them were put to death for what they believed. But they all stayed in the faith. Come on, say amen.
Amen.